Dad joke time. The people living on Silent Hill were so bored, they wanted to move somewhere with a lot of excitement. Where did they move? Extremely Loud Hill. Yeah, I know. Silent Hill rumors won't die, and I don't know if I like this rumor. Stay with me. So there was some information that came out yesterday in an article from Windows Central. I'm going to go through this article and then we'll discuss what it could possibly mean for the franchise. In some rather massive news yesterday, Bloober Team and Konami officially announced that it has signed a strategic cooperation agreement that'll see the two companies working together on new projects. In a statement released by Bloober Team, the developer revealed that they will be jointly developing selected contents and exchanging know-how with Konami. The Japanese publisher then said it was excited to work with Bloober Team and other highly regarded development partners to produce games from existing and new IPs. Bloober Team also mentioned that it's working on a project that claims is much bigger than the medium, and this sentiment was shared almost immediately after the medium was released. Additionally, we know Bloober Team is in the process of expanding the team and recently hired a combat animator. This studio typically avoids traditional combat in its horror experiences, but since Silent Hill likely would require it, it potentially shows even more signs of a Blooper-developed Silent Hill project. So with all of those coincidences and then yesterday's announcement of the partnership with Konami, there does seem to be some more traction around Silent Hill and the game actually being created. And whether or not Bloober Team is the studio that's going to do that, here are my thoughts. I think it's a mistake, and I'll tell you why. I have nothing against Bloober Team. I really enjoyed The Blair Witch. Most people didn't. I thought that the medium was a step back for Bloober Team. I don't think that the medium was a really compelling game. I thought there were a lot of problems in the game, from animation to pacing. Stuff like that just shouldn't happen. And again, they are a small studio, so if they're having problems with things like that in the medium, giving them a franchise as big as Silent Hill, I just think would be a mistake. You have to give this project to somebody like a Blue Point Games, or somebody just bigger with a lot more resources behind them and a lot more experience behind them in making third-person action survival horror games. So let's take a look at the pedigree of games Bloober Team has created. So they worked on and created Layers of Fear, which was an absolute fantastic horror game. Layers of Fear 2, some feel that was a step back compared to the original. I happen to think it was as well. It was a good game, but it was not as good as Layers of Fear. Then they did Blair Witch, and I enjoyed that game for what it was. It was much more focused on puzzle solving and presence within the world. It was a slow burn, but I felt it was a good game. Observer System Redux was very good as well. First person, a neo-noir sci-fi drama. You're a detective. Very good story and a unique art style. And then they went to the medium, and that's where I think they went backwards. There were a lot of problems with the game, as I said, animation being one of them, pacing being one of them. It just felt like a last generation game, sort of the tail end of the Xbox 360 era. We had games that sort of looked like that, animation that was like that, and I didn't think it was a step up from things like Layers of Fear and Blair Witch and Observer. So could they do a good job with Silent Hill, taking all of the experience they have with those games that I mentioned, and creating something great with Silent Hill? I don't know. Again, it's a huge franchise. There's huge expectations behind it. People are waiting for it. They've been talking about Silent Hill nonstop for years, and it is the thinking man's Resident Evil. It's a much better experience, I feel, than Resident Evil. And the world, the gameplay, the tone has to be correct. It can't be just another Resident Evil clone or, you know, Evil Within, Evil Within 2, something like that. It has to have its own unique identity, and it has to feel like Silent Hill. Silent Hill 2 was one of the best horror games ever, and people are looking for that experience. They're not looking for a carbon copy of Resident Evil. So hopefully, whoever is given the job of resurrecting Silent Hill is up to the challenge and does the job that fans and the game deserve. Now, this article does its best to spin some coincidences together to make it seem like Bloober Team is that choice. It references the CEO of Bloober Team stating that the developer was working on an existing horror IP from a, quote, very famous gaming publisher. He then went on to say that he believed it would cause quite a stir once it was revealed. And even on Twitter, the idea of Blooper Team working on Silent Hill has absolutely caused some commotion. There was a statement from the developer's CEO, and that was pointing to Blooper Team developed Silent Hill. So how do you feel about Blooper Team being given the keys to the Silent Hill universe? Have you played their games in the past? What do you think about their games? Do you think they've got the talent to resurrect Silent Hill? Or do you think it should be given to somebody with much more of a pedigree in the industry in creating games of this style? Let me know what you think in the comment section below about this. I'm excited for Silent Hill and I want it to be good. I didn't like the medium. I couldn't even finish the game. It just did not resonate with me at all after their previous work. And I don't know if they're the best choice for this project, if it is in fact happening. Think about liking and subscribing and sharing out on your favorite social media platform of choice. And I'll see you in the next video.